This is the brand new member of the ZenBook Pro family, the Pro Duo UX581GV. When you fire it up, it takes your breath away. It's like when Keanu Reeves went on stage at E3 and some developer in the audience shouted at him, "You're breathtaking." The dual screen setup is nothing that new. Even the previous ZenBook Pro UX580, launched nearly a year ago, had a touchpad capable of morphing in a secondary screen at a touch of a button. Even the competition tried the dual screen approach. HP Omen X was having a secondary Full HD 6-inch display, which could be used for pretty much anything helpful, especially in gaming. But nothing comes close to Asus's implementation. The screen below is a full 14-inch 3840x1100 pixels display, a real extension of the main screen, and it looks just amazing. Yep, that's how the future looks like. ZenBook Pro Duo integrates a 4K HDR OLED panel. This panel was announced by Samsung at the beginning of this year. It's specially made for laptops, with a brightness between 0.0005 and 600 nits, a 120,000:1 contrast ratio, display HDR and HDR10, and a 100% DCI-P3 color space coverage. The stuff the dreams are made of. I honestly didn't believe that we'll see such a panel so soon in a $3,000 laptop. But these guys took a huge leap forward, a spectacular tour de force, just in time for their 30 years anniversary. Another great advantage of the OLED screens in general, and this Samsung panel in particular, is the ultra-slim bezels, just a few millimeters thick. And so, this ZenBook Pro Duo has a screen-to-body ratio of 89%, which allows a way more compact body, but also a futuristic look. And if the DCI-P3 standard is widely used in cinema industry, it's for the better, because, as I already said, this one is a 100% DCI-P3, which makes it ideal for people in this field. Same for photo editing, not to mention that this surreal OLED panel boasts a fabulous 133% sRGB color space coverage. When it comes to organizing space around the keyboard and the ergonomics of this space, we always like the way Asus shot two rabbits with one bullet, having touchpad and numpad in the same place at the same time. Numpad was the magic word, especially when we had to deal with pushed back keyboards, like we often encountered on the Zephyrus S range due to cooling issues, or on Omen X2S due to secondary screen issues. Unlike the previous versions, the new numpad 2.0 offers two levels of brightness, and unlike the first numpad version, even when the keys are activated, the cursor may be used, thanks to the smart software. Regarding the actual physical keyboard, the keys have a 1.4mm stroke, which leads to a pleasant experience. The Intel Core i9-9980HK CPU is a hungry one and is natural, having 8 physical cores and 16 threads. A lot of mouths to feed, that's why at 45W TDP it's not surprising. And it's also natural to have a thicker case to rest assured that the CPU is cooled enough. What's still a wonder for me is how they managed to add a secondary touchscreen in the upper part of the chassis in a 2.4cm body, including the lid, right above the area where the heat pipes are, and actually the entire engine of this laptop. This sandwich is a hell of an engineering achievement to manage somehow not to overheat the secondary screen. Especially when, besides the Core i9 CPU, Asus added an Nvidia RTX 2060 with 6GB GDDR6 VRAM. And yes, it's the RTX 2060 laptop version, with a 960MHz base clock and 1200MHz boost clock, not the Max-Q version we were waiting for since January 2019, which never came to light. And that's how this laptop is good enough also for gaming, even if we don't really tolerate the glossy screens for this kind of activity. But if you don't mind this small detail, why not? Anyway, adding up to the already mentioned specs, the screen covered in protective glass, and last but not least the generous 71 watts per hour battery, we guess that the 2.5 kilos of this laptop are pretty well justified. So, what is this laptop about? It is just another unusual concept, or we stare right into the future? It's hard to have a right away answer. If that touch bar on the MacBook Pro found some useful applications for itself, like shortcuts in some apps, In ZenBook Pro Duo, you can bring right to your fingertips entire submenus of an app and manipulate them however you want. Because in this particular case, we're talking about a full-fledged display, which can even complement or double the main screen functionality. You can drop here Photoshop or Premiere tabs or the minimap of a game. Sky is the limit when it comes to efficiency. Time will tell if this device is the first in a new breed of laptops. We'll be back soon with a solid review of this laptop to see how well it moves, how good is the build quality, how hot it gets, things that are hard to answer right now. Anyway, until then, leave a comment and tell us what do you think about the new ZenBook Pro Duo, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you all.